All right, I just got my Condor 3-day assault pack the other day in the mail. So I'm going to unbox it here. I got it off of Amazon for, I think it was $65. So let's take a look. Box out of the way. I got it pulled out, and here it is. Condor 3-day assault pack. Condoroutdoors.com. I chose Condor. I did some looking around online, like Maxpedition and 5-11 bags. They were just way too pricey. We're, you know, talking like hundreds of dollars for a bag that's going to do pretty much the same job. I've dealt with Condor products before. I used to work at a gun shop locally here, and we sold their gun cases and other items like that. And they had really good quality and for a good price, too. I got the Coyote Tan or brown. It was only $65 opposed to the multicam, which was, I believe, like $127. So you're saving a good bit of money just by going with brown, which nowadays this is pretty much what the military, I know the Navy and the Marine Corps anyway, issue us, is just Coyote brown. Because, you know, spring, summer, fall, winter, there's always brown. You know, leaves, dirt, bark, so on, there's always brown. I mean, for those of you who hunt, if you've ever seen a deer, when they just stand perfectly still, if you're not paying attention, you won't even know he's there. And they're not wearing multicam. So, that makes a lot of sense. Especially down here in the south. We don't get any snow. If we do, it's very rare. But there's those of you who are like, oh, well, I live in Wisconsin or, you know, Maine, where it snows most of the time. What am I supposed to do? Well, that's a real easy fix. Just take a white garbage bag and use it as a bag cover, and problem solved. But let's go into it. I did look at, like many of y'all, I'm sure you looked at other videos where other people did reviews and unboxings. You got your outside bag, or the most outer compartment, I should say. Pretty good, and this also extends to give you even more room. You also got your Velcro here to put your name tapes or morale patches or, you know, whichever you feel like doing. Of course, Molly Webbin, so you can hook on more gear. You know, your fixed knives, med pack, whatever you want to put add to it. On the zippers, you see they actually have overlap right here. Help keep it rain resistant and the flaps over it, so it's even more rain resistant. So like I said, you're getting a pretty good quality for the price. Like I said, I believe I paid $65 for just, I believe the OD green and the black is the same way. You got three outer pockets, and of course, compression straps, also a Molly gear. Which you could fit, if you really wanted to put like some kind of water system or a canteen or something, it would fit just fine. But me, I'd rather hang a canteen on the outside and have this to store more items versus this whole pouch being used for one item. And what I love about this bag is they give you just as many compartments, and individual compartments as like a Maxpedition bag would have, opposed to like the opposite side, the really cheap bags that were like this, which were like $30, didn't have any individual compartments, you know, onto it. You also have three individual compartments right in here, one big master bag in here, and of course you can just put stuff in between, like your larger items. And of course you got this compartment. Carry extra magazines for your M4, AR-15, you know, three individual pen slots, spots for paperwork, or maps. Don't worry if you can use this for a radio too. I'm going to turn this bag into my bug out bag. I've never really been a prepper, you know, other than, you know, keeping some water and candles and stuff for bad weather situations, but it seems like more and more people nowadays are starting to get into this. So I figure it doesn't hurt to be prepared, definitely. So I'm not going to go to the extreme as like you see on TV where people like have 20 years of food and build a compound and all this. I just want to be ready in case something does happen, especially the way things are going these days. So it doesn't hurt in that sense. And even if I didn't use this as my 3-day bag, I would probably definitely use this in my military job. I mean, this is even some better quality than the stuff that we get issued. I mean, you even have, you have straps in here. Carry your laptop, which a lot of guys, I know when we deploy, we carry a laptop. It's like our entertainment, our movies, work, everything. Even though you're deployed, you still have to do paperwork, evaluations, and so on like that. And everybody shares movies. So this is great. I can carry it, and this is reinforced in the back, so I don't have to worry about it getting, you know, crunched up or cracked, whatever I got in here. And you have, I like how it just opens all the way out. So if you had all your clothes and stuff in here, it's just right here. You're not having to reach into the entire bag to find what you need. You can just open it up. Oh, there's my socks. Grab them and you're good. And also you have more individual compartments, you know, to keep like your bathroom kit and so on like that. Keep things more organized. It's a lot easier to find stuff when it's definitely organized versus just throwing in an empty bag with no kind of organization. Then you're just, especially if you're in the dark rooting around trying to find something. Oh yeah, you have handles on all sides. You have them on the side, the top. So you can just, no matter what way the bag is laying, when you come up to it, you can just grab it and go. Which is awesome in my opinion. And of course, we move on to padding. The padding feels really good. I mean, I'm impressed with it, especially for the amount of money I paid. I don't have to worry about this rubbing my hips raw when I'm carrying it. I like how it comes all the way around, and at least, you know, it cushions your back. And they have the small, like a pad for the small of your back, which there's Velcro that I can feel inside of here. So if you really want to, you can stash something else up underneath here. I like how they left it ventilated, so you can have, if you, you know, your back starts sweating, you can still get air to it to keep you cool and get rid of the moisture, but you still have padding here. It doesn't come with a hydration bladder, but you can add one to it. Right inside of here, you open up. Condor sells their own hydration bladder. It's only like $18 and it fits perfectly up in here, of course, which is a lot cheaper than going to buy a Camelback bladder, and it's going to do the same job. I mean, you got hooks, and you soak it through and strap it, and it'll hang with the Velcro. And on some of the other reviews I saw, they never mentioned this, which is a nice surprise. There's a big piece of plastic in here, which allows the stiffen, which what stiffens it up. And I love that, because one, it's going to keep your camelback from sweating through, which I don't know, in some situations, like here in Florida when it's 98 degrees outside, that feels really nice. But if anything, it keeps your bag up and it keeps the bag and everything else from getting crushed. But also, there's even the inside is insulated, so it'll keep your water even cooler for longer. So that's awesome. And then on each side, you have these Velcro covers so you can stick your water hose out on whichever side you prefer. You know, if you're right-handed, left-handed, so on. And also they have little areas on top, like right here, so you can run your 550 cord through and tie down your sleeping bag, bedroll, or what other gear, you know, machete. And same thing on the bottom. We got your drainage all on the bottom in case something spills, or if your camelback did, or your hydration system did leak. Also more areas to tie, which when we got issued our Alice packs, they had the same thing, and this is what everybody used to tie their sleep system to. So, and that worked great. So, I mean, it's pretty wide. It's definitely can hold a lot more gear than I thought it would just looking online. It also stands up on its own, so you can just grab it and go. So that's my review of the Condor 3-day bag. If you would, feel free to subscribe. Comment below. Let me know what you thought. You know, if I can improve, or if you thought it was great, either way, I hope this helped you out. I know it helped me watch another review, so I knew what I was getting into before I purchased something. And if anything, it's just maybe I gave you something to think about. So thank you for watching, and I hope you check in for our next video.